technical invention by itself isn't necessarily a fit for the future. It's how it's used. We've seen that just giving people access to the ability to communicate with each other leads naturally to a whole lot of really wonderful things, but also it can lead to really unpleasant things. So what it's going to take is going to have to take some specific coordinated effort to look at what's happening on the internet and change and re-engineer some of it. For example, tweak the way social networks work, build new social networks which allow us to solve the problem of global democracy, for example. There's lots more that we expect from the internet that we can achieve, but it won't come by itself. Well, the Internet of Things is a lot about automation. It's a lot about machines doing things, simple things that I should, so I don't have to do them myself. So it's just as when we run a spreadsheet on a laptop, it helps me do my taxes, so I don't have to do it myself. The Internet of Things allows me to walk into my house and for things to happen or go into the workplace and things happen automatically. It's exciting. It's been exciting. I mean, sort of things like gadgets around the home have been around for a long time. So really what's happening now is the most important clearly is that they're being connected. And what's clearly important is that they're connected to systems that work well together, so that all, no matter who you buy your Internet of Things gadgets from, whether industry or consumer, they should all work together. You should have interoperability between them. And from the consumer, what's important is the respect of users' data, the users' rights to own their data. Looking into the future, trying to predict the future, is something I've always declined. I will say what I would like to see, but I won't say what I... I've never tried to guess what's coming, because it's too hard to be... The problems on the internet are many, so we can make a list of them. But I think that obviously, some of them start off with people's privacy not being abused. Not so much, I think, recently with things like the Cambridge Analytica debacle. It's not people worried about that their privacy, like their somebody will see photographs of them. It's that they realize that their personal data has been used in a system, and that system has been used to manipulate people. And so people have ended up being persuaded to vote against their best interests. And so breakage of that system, breakage of the democratic system, which is connected to the privacy problem, but also obviously the problems with the hate speech, and the place where we draw the line between hate speech and free speech, is we have to investigate further. Whether it works and whether it is good for people, whether it is good for humanity. I think nowadays students are in a different world to the world we were a generation ago. And a generation ago, very much, it was there were fields that you studied. And so when you could study physics, or you could study math, or you could study economics. But now students have to be all over the place to a certain extent. They start, you find that they end up studying here, then getting a job here, and then I think the important thing is to make sure that there are many, that your life involves understanding in many different areas, and that you use the interrelationship between those areas to do new exciting things. It's a much more complicated world than when I was a student, but it's exciting because of the speed with which you can design new things and the speed with which you can research things.